Russia has said it has successfully test-launched the 3M-22 Zircon hypersonic cruise missile from a submarine for the first time. The Russian Navy's nuclear-powered Yasen-class submarine, Severodvinsk, carried out the missile test. This is a major development since it's the first time ever that a hypersonic cruise missile has been fired from a submarine by any country. Yasen class with Zircon is a lethal combination and gives Russia a capability that's not possessed by any other country. In this video, Defense Updates discusses why the successful launch of the Zircon missile from Yasen class attack submarine is alarming news for the US. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. According to the Russian Ministry of Defense, two launches took place on October 4, 2021. One was conducted surfaced, and the other was when submerged. The ministry did not provide many details about the first one, which was conducted when surfaced. A video was released to depict this particular launch. The official statement said the second test launch was carried out while the boat was in the White Sea at a depth of just over 130 feet, and the missile hit a target in the neighboring Barents Sea. The ministry didn't provide any details regarding the total distance traveled by Zircons or the max speed reached by the missiles. Severodvinsk is the lead vessel of the Yasen class. Yasen is one submarine class that the US military is concerned about. The Yasen class, unlike older Soviet vessels, are multi-mission boats similar to American Seawolf or Virginia classes. Submarines of this class have technically unlimited range and endurance since they're nuclear powered. Yasen class is a sophisticated and extremely quiet design that American officials have stated is on par with US Navy submarines. Sometime back, the US Navy's top submarine officer, Rear Admiral Dave Johnson, stated, "We'll be facing tough potential opponents. One only has to look at the Severodvinsk, first vessel of the Yasen class, Russia's version of a nuclear-guided missile submarine, SSGN. He was so impressed with the ship that he'd built a model from unclassified data so that he could look at it every day on his way to his office." In 2018, Russian President Vladimir Putin announced that Russia was developing a series of new weapons. Zircon was one of them. As per President Putin's address in the Russian Federal Assembly, the Zircon is capable of reaching speeds of Mach 9. President Putin mentioned that the missile is able to destroy both seagoing and land targets. As per reports, the Zircon will have both a radar target seeker and an optical electronic complex to detect and track targets. The missile could be equipped with a high explosive warhead or even a tactical nuclear warhead. While there are several ways to achieve hypersonic speed, Zircon is thought to use a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. They rely on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. There are four aspects that make Zircon a lethal weapon. 1. The speed makes it almost unstoppable. It's to be noted that Even the excellent Aegis system equipping the American Arleigh Burke-class destroyers will be too slow to react in time. 2. Since Zircon is heavy and fast, it will have lots of kinetic energy, which will come into play along with the explosive warhead, and a single hit from it could be enough to cripple even a supercarrier. 3. Another important aspect of the missile is its plasma cloud. As per multiple reports, the air pressure in front of the weapon forms a plasma cloud as it moves and is completely covered by a plasma cloud during the flight. The plasma cloud would absorb radio frequencies emitted from radars, and since the waves are not reflected back, it will essentially mean that the missile will be partially invisible. It's highly likely that the missile will be detected very late, and this will make intercepting Zircon almost impossible with the current air defense systems. 4. The missile can actually fly at low altitude, and hence it's very hard to defend against, as the radar will catch it much later when compared to traditional missiles. Russia has been developing asymmetric weapons to counter the American military, and Zircon is a key weapon. It's to be noted that America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report had stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range, conventional, and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. So, a silent submarine, like Severodvinsk, armed with Zircon, is a major threat for the U.S. and NATO forces. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.